This is MJ with MinIO. Welcome back to the Kubernetes overview portion of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course.
So next we're going to talk about services. Services act like load balancers essentially inside the cluster. So if you have multiple different pods, you can think of those in a typical environment, either in the cloud or in your data center as individual virtual machines, you would put a load balancer in front of them so that they all receive the same amount of traffic or some defined amount of traffic through that singular IP space of that load balancer. So services are that, but in software inside the Kubernetes cluster. So services are an abstraction which defines a logical set of pods and a policy by which to access them. And this is sometimes called a microservice. The set of pods targeted by a service is usually determined by a selector. So you're basically going to have some sort of definition of what this service is looking for to attach to, usually a name. And then that service will address all of the things of that particular name and pass traffic to them. So you can think of the service, as I said earlier, as a software load balancer running inside your cluster that routes connections to various pods inside your environment. That allows you to easily scale the pods without changing the endpoint. So if you have the service up and running, then you can point external things to that service name, and that service name and service IP will always stay the same. But you can now add and remove pods behind that service, and it doesn't matter. The end client that's accessing that service doesn't know the difference, but the service will know how many underlying pods it can actually pass traffic to. For MinIO, the service is a way that we can access the MinIO server either from within inside the cluster, or as you're gonna see here in a little bit, from outside the cluster. So the typical path for that would be that an external to this particular deployment, or external to this particular namespace potentially, would come into the service, not go directly to the pod, and then the service would determine which pods are available and which pods should be receiving traffic from that request. So there's two types of services that we're going to be talking about today. One of them is called cluster IP, and the other is the node port service. So first we'll talk about the cluster IP. The cluster IP service is the default service type. So if you do not define what type of service you want, this will basically be the type that automatically gets chosen. What this does is exposes the service on the cluster internal IP for a group of pods. So again, this is inside the cluster only. This is not going to allow you external access to these pods. And it's designed for internal communications between pods within the Kubernetes cluster. And the next piece we're going to talk about is node port. So cluster IP can be exposed externally using a node port service or an ingress, but it doesn't have to be. So in tight association with the cluster IP is the node port service. So node port service is going to expose an internal port in the range of these 30,000 to 32767 to all the nodes in the cluster. So basically this is a way to get traffic in from the outside on a high numbered port and let it access the cluster IP, which will then pass that traffic into the appropriate pods. This automatically creates a cluster IP service. So it's not like you have to create a cluster IP, then a node port. When you create a node port, a cluster IP will automatically be created. And the node port service can then be accessed externally from your cluster by requesting the node IP or some name if you've assigned a DNS name and the node port assigned here. So for MinIO, we can use the node port service to expose the MinIO server to the outside world if we wanted to. Now there's another way that we're going to talk about later, which is to use an ingress, which will not require someone to type in this special port. But let's go ahead and jump into the demo and I'll show you how these work. So here we are in our demo environment. And if I take a look at our cluster IP service, you can see here that we are defining a service up top called cluster IP. We're not giving it a definition. Remember I said, if you don't define what type of service this is, it's going to automatically create a cluster IP. And this is basically going to say, create a Nginx cluster IP, and the cluster service or the cluster IP service is going to be listening on port 80. And the target port of the pods that it's going to be passing traffic to is also port 80. In this example, we're going to bring up just a deployment with some Nginx in it, and that's going to be listening on port 80. So the traffic flow will be that it comes in to the service, the cluster IP service, and then the cluster IP service we'll be able to address all three replicas and pass traffic across them through that service or load balancer into port 80 on all of these pods. So let's go ahead and deploy this. So you can see that a cluster IP was created and an Nginx deployment was created. You can see that I did not define a namespace here, so I wanted to point this out to you. This actually got deployed into the default namespace because I was not specific with deploying this into the MinIO namespace, so that's important to take a look at. What we can do is say k get all, and without defining anything, it's going to say, okay, they're not defining a namespace, so we want to look in the default namespace. And what we can see in here is that we have a deployment with three pods, and we also have the cluster IP, which is deployed here. And this is the cluster IP that is deployed actually inside here. There's also the deployment definition and the automatically created replica set for this deployment. So again, this is for internal services only for cluster IP. Now let's talk about our node port so we can expose this outside of our cluster. So you can see within the node port definition, we're also defining service. This time I am giving the namespace of MinIO, so it will go into that proper namespace. And we're calling the selector Nginx NP because that's what it's going to be looking for. So anything named Nginx NP will be what comes under the purview of this particular service. And the unique thing here is that we are saying this cluster IP should be listening on port 80. The target port of the pods will be port 80 as well. And the type is node port. And then we're also defining that we want to use the port 30,000 as our external node port. So if you don't select a node port, it's automatically going to select one for you. But in this case, I like defining node port so it's not random. So in this case, I've chosen 30,000 to be exposed externally. Let me pull up a browser window real quick so that you can see that there's nothing running here because we have not run this deployment yet. So as you can see here, if we go to our host IP 30,000, there is nothing there yet because we have not defined a path in, so there's no node port open yet. If we come back over here to our terminal, we can do k apply minus f node port, and it will go ahead and apply that. And now if we do a k get pods minus n minio, we can see that there is now a new single pod for the Nginx deployment for that. And if we do a get all in that namespace, what we can see up here is all of the pods that are deployed, but we can also see that there's some services here. So now there's a Nginx node port service defined here, and you can see that it's saying inside it's listening on port 80, but outside it's listening on port 30,000. So now if we come back over to our web page, I didn't even have to refresh, it just auto-refreshed. You can now see that I'm accessing this service from 30,000 on the outside of my cluster. So now this is exposed to the outside world. So if we want to look at the logs of this for incoming traffic, what we can do is actually do k get pods minus n minio and grab the name that's associated with that node port service. And then we do k logs. We'll do a minus f for follow, which basically means it's going to stream the logs on the screen and not immediately exit out. And then we will define the name of the pod that we care about and the namespace that we wanted to check in. So now you can see that there are a number of logs here for this Nginx pod. Basically, it's logging incoming traffic. You can see that this is web browser traffic, you know, Mozilla, Apple WebKit, Chrome, Safari. And if I come into our page here and I refresh, you'll see that the logs scroll. So this is basically passing traffic from the outside on the node port 30,000 to a cluster IP, which is a service running that's addressing this one pod, and it's passing traffic into this pod so that the web page can be served back out to the end user, which is me in this case. So that's how node ports work.
Thanks for joining us for this Kubernetes overview topic as part of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. We look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks and have a good one.